Hello everyone, welcome to a new video of the Indicator Store, and today I'm going to continue with what was pending on the previous video, how to define a trend line so we can filter signals. Like for example, here we have a lot of signals, shorts and longs, but there are also signals on the other direction. How we can define if here the market is going down and here it is going up. Or even we can also define that the market is going anywhere, so we avoid taking signals on that place. So the most, my preferred three lines are the linear regression with a period more or less big, the HMA also with a period big, and finally the exponential moving average, in that order. But the first two are my preferred. Let's give an example with the linear regression. And what I am looking at the line is the slope, not the position of the line with the, against the price, only the slope. Let's take a look, for example, at the linear regression of 83. I usually use 50, 83, 100. So here we can see that starting at this point, ending here, the slope is negative. Again, I don't care if the line is above or below the price. And it is sloping up until more or less here, maybe in this area. That means that, of course, I am not going to take the best of the best signal. Here, for example, this long is not going to be executed because the filter has a lag. Same here. We are taking longs from this point. So we take this long, other here. And the first short, this one is not executed because the line has a delay to change the slope, but that happens always. When we use a filter, the first reversal signal is not executed because the filter always has a lag. Now, something else that we need to check, the line that we decide to use to define the trend line must be smooth, because we are looking at the slope of that line. If you want to calculate the slope of that line, you can use marker slope, but if you don't have markers, you can also use the momentum indicator. We already saw a video about that. With the momentum indicator, you can set, by the way, the momentum has different names on different languages. If you have the platform in Spanish, for example, the name of the indicator is impulse. If you use a period of one and on input series you place the indicator that you want to calculate the slope, here it is a linear regression of 83. So inside the input series you place the indicator linear regression 83. And then my preferred method for the line is in bar mode for the plot style. It looks much better because we can see here from this point to this point the slope is negative, it is sloping down, and from here to here it is sloping up. And it started to be positive here. There are just two bars where the slope of this line is negative. It is not visible, but if you increase the zoom, now you can see that the line is going down. This is noise, and we can remove that noise by increasing the period, but the problem is the bigger the period, the bigger also the lag or the delay. And now you can see how far is the new pivot from the previous. We get a lot of bars of delay. Another method is let's go to the other side. Let's decrease the period. So now it is faster, but of course the smooth is it is less smoother. Now let's check the slope of that line. So we need to change the period inside the momentum. So now we can see that the slope of this line is almost zero here. But anyway, the idea is we can increase, or we can make the reaction or the change of the slope faster. The problem is the smoothness of the line. Now let's try with the HMA. The HMA is faster, so we should use a bigger period. Let's try with a period of 50, and we get something that we can see it is a little faster than the linear regression. The changing point is more or less here. On this area where there is a pullback, there is almost no change, so this short is okay for both lines because the slope is negative for both. Here we have a trend change, and here for the linear regression is almost horizontal, so maybe taking this long may be difficult because it is almost zero. So we have a linear regression of 50 and an HMA of 50. For the EMA, you can try that for yourself. This is not the best of the best lines to choose. But now let's see how we can remove the noise of those lines, avoiding these flat areas. So we can smooth the line again, but now with something faster, to avoid adding more lag. So we can nest this indicator to an SMA with a period really, really small, 3, 4, 5 bars. That's almost the same. Let's see how we can do this. Let's try with the linear regression of 50. So now we add an SMA. On NinjaTrader, we can nest almost all indicators, one inside another. Not all of them, but most of them. So we can add an SMA with a really fast period, only 5 bars. So we take only 5 points and divide by 5. Of what? Of the linear regression, not the price. So inside here, we place the linear regression of 50. And for the result, let's draw with the same color than the linear regression in black, but using a dashed line, so we can see the difference. And here we can see that we get a really smoother version of the line with not a big lag. Here we can see that the horizontal part is gone. If we want to check the difference on the slope between the smoothed and the not smoothed line, we can add another momentum. So we add another momentum. Of only one bar, of, no de linear regression, but the SMA of the linear regression. SMA. Now we are nesting three indicators, one inside the other. SMA of 5 bars of the linear regression of 50. Okay, and the result, we can get the same histogram, so we can compare one with the other, and we can see that here, when the black line gets horizontal on the smoothed version, it is still positive, not reaching the zero area, and we are not adding too much delay, because we are only doing an average of 5 bars, and we can see how important is the smoothing that we are doing here. For example, it is almost zero, and on the smoothed version it is okay. We can overlap one with the other. We can change this to, instead of using a histogram, using lines, so we can overlap this with the other, and now we can see the lag. There is a lag between one crossover and the other, but the result is more useful. Here, for example, it is bigger than zero, the slope, and we only get 3 bars of lag everywhere. For example, on this trade, on this case, we have a short here, and we also have a long. For the long, this is okay, because both lines, the linear regression and also the average version, are negative, so the long is gone. But what happens with the short? If we look at the linear regression, the slope is positive, so we are not taking the short. But if instead we are, if we look at the SMA of the linear regression, then it is still negative. It is not so visible, but if we look at the lines, the dashed line versus the black line, this is almost horizontal, but the slope is still negative. But instead, the linear regression is sloping up here, and that little sloping up is going to avoid taking the short. The HMA, the red line, is also doing the same. You can see that it is also sloping up, and you can do exactly the same with the HMA. We can calculate the smoothed version of the HMA. So we add an SMA of 5 bars, and we can use an SMA of 3 or 5. Of the HMA of 50 bars. Ah, let's use the same color, red, but in dashed style. And it looks like this. We can see that there is a delay between the other, the unfiltered version. But for example, here on this short, let's see how it looks. The original line is sloping up, but the dashed line, the smoothed, is always sloping down, so we are not going to miss that short. So usually when we want to calculate a trend line, we need to use a big period line, but to decrease the noise, we can average again with something faster, for example an SMA 5 or 3. That way we don't need to use a bigger period on the original line. On this case, if I want to choose, my preferred line is between the linear regression and the HMA. I prefer the linear regression. It is faster to be calculated, and there is less lag when you have a lot of linear regressions calculating at the same time on the same chart. But this is something that you need to decide by yourself. Another thing that we can do is when do nothing. Instead of taking longs when the slope is positive and taking shorts when it is negative, we can define, okay, positive, but how much? It should be positive and bigger than a threshold. And for the short, the same. It must be negative, but below a negative threshold. Here, for example, we have a lot of longs. All these arrows are long signals, but if we look at the slope or the average of the slope, we can specify the threshold. So we only want long signals when the slope is positive and bigger than a threshold. So we avoid taking signals when the market is going nowhere, like for example here, where the slope is not so negative and not so positive. So this is one of the many things that we can do. Hope this video has been useful for you. Any question or comment, you can contact me on the chat room that we have on Discord. The instructions to log are on the description of this video, and don't forget, the access is free. Thank you everyone. Bye bye.